Sisters! James Charles here, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. As you guys can see, I have a very, very special guest for today's brand new video.
Man, what are we doing here? What's the title of this video?
Hi, Jeff.
Hi, James.
For today's video, if you guys saw my video a few weeks ago with the Vlog Squad, Jeff was there and made a cute little cameo moment. And after our little collab, pretty much every single comment on the video was about our relationship.
David's stupid haircut. Our relationship.
Yes.
Okay, yeah, it's true. My whole life has become James Charles. My entire tag photos has all been taken over by the sisters shipping us. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, thanks guys, I appreciate it. It's really good. Forced us into a relationship, and now we're here for this video today.
Yeah, clear this up, because I got a lot of hate at one point. You broke down crying in a hotel room in London or something.
Yeah.
And then everybody says, it's Jeff. First of all, we met one time during the video, and then all of a sudden I'm the guy that broke your heart in London.
Well,
I've never even been to London.
It was not Jeff.
I'm getting backlash. Jeff would have canceled for nothing.
I mean, you could have been there for me.
But James, clear this up first. Jeff is a straight man.
This is true. Jeff is a straight man.
We're good friends now.
Yes, this is true. Do you want to share your Valentine's Day text that you sent me? I was going to bring that up later on in the video, but we can just drop it right now.
What did I say? I forget. Say it.
You texted me late Valentine's Day night and said, "Happy Valentine's Day, beautiful."
Oh, well, that's just me being friendly. I send that to David and all my tough guy friends in prison.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
For today's video, Daddy Jeff is here, and we're teaming up because Jeff is going to do my makeup, and I pulled a bunch of questions from the boyfriend tag, and we are going to ask each other the questions and figure out if maybe one day we would be compatible.
Okay, deal. But whatever, I don't know how to cut hair, and I make videos on cutting hair, so how hard can it be to do makeup?
Yeah, if you don't know how to do it.
Yeah, and if it doesn't work out, we wash it off.
This is so
true. You can't do that with hair.
That's true, you can't. That's why I didn't get a haircut from you.
Oh, that's why, huh? Unleash your inner artist. It's my favorite part.
Okay.
Let's jump into it.
Okay, are you ready for this?
I learned in the video, your first one, you rub some primer on.
Yes.
Do I rub that on your face?
Yes, please.
Is that what you do professionally?
Yes.
You don't tell them you put this on?
No.
Okay. You just rub this on?
Yeah, please touch me all over.
Okay. Just two dudes doing each other's makeup?
Uh-huh.
Now am I gonna talk my way out of this one? Okay, that's on there pretty good. Now what do I do with the hands? Lotion.
Just use them for later.
Jesus.
You were the one that in the last video requested lotion for a full body massage.
Okay, you're right, I did.
You did.
I got a dry sense of humor. Come off very sarcastic. You don't know when I'm joking or not. Neither do I. Do you want to give me a little walkthrough here?
Okay, yeah, so your next step is gonna be foundation.
Okay, this is the worn this way.
You can put it on like the back of your hand.
Okay, the back.
Yeah.
Teach me those little tricks like that.
Okay.
That's good.
Okay. Got you.
This we basically just rub all over your face, right?
Yeah, you pounce it in.
Start on the forehead, right?
Sure.
Oh man, this is like paint.
It is. You're an artiste today. Paint me like a French girl.
Why didn't you just ask me to give you a haircut?
Because you're not very good at it.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
I'm much better at haircuts than makeup.
Coachella's in 2 days from now. I cannot have a botched haircut for Coachella.
I would never botch your hair. I never have in my life. I've never messed somebody's hair up.
That's a total lie. You have video documentation on your YouTube channel.
You know what? I'm gonna take those down because those are jokes and it's affecting my business.
Yeah, clearly.
And I had like my ex be like, oh, you flirted with him in that video. I know how you flirt. You used to flirt with me.
You did flirt with me in that video.
I'm just being sarcastic though.
No.
I mean, like, yeah, I'm being nice and, like, I'm, like, joking around, but I don't want to mess with anybody's heads here, you know?
This is true. I called you out on Valentine's Day after you said that to me.
How do you get into the hair? You just kind of blend it?
Just blend it, yeah. What are three qualities that you would look for in a long-term relationship?
That's a good question. You gotta have a good sense of humor.
Yeah.
That's the most important.
You tell me I'm funny to every single DM I send you?
Yeah, okay, second one, you have to be a woman because...
I'm a woman.
You just gotta have some sort of ambition in life. You know, like you gotta want
to
do
things. I have ambition.
You do.
I'm famous.
You got 2 out of 3. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
I watched the first video. What were you doing with your eyebrows back then?
Stop!
You were just taking a Sharpie.
I know, they were bad.
What's your three qualities you look for in a partner?
I would say my like biggest one is also a sense of humor. I would say my number two would be like understanding is like a huge thing for me.
Yeah.
Just because like the life that I live is strange. And like I need someone who like not gets it, but like
common
is willing
sense.
to learn. A lot of
common sense, yeah.
And then my third would be like, probably a hot barber.
Oh, okay.
You know, just so I can get my hair cut all the time, you know?
I know one. Your barber.
Sophie?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's lesbian and has a wife.
So. Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah, taste of my own medicine.
Yeah,
there.
It looks like I'm to the second one with Jeff Winnick.
That's next.
Concealer.
Okay. Concealer you just glob on.
Yes.
Mix it around there. Good. Give it a shake.
Mm-hmm. Jeff, where did we first meet? Question two, boyfriend.
Here, time. Right? We met on FaceTime.
We did meet on FaceTime for the first time.
Yeah. And then we met here in this room.
Yeah, we did. Where all the magic happened.
And we've never left and since. He's had me chained up in here. Please help if you see this. Smash like 2 million likes and they'll release me. Okay, blend it back in.
Yeah. I think I slid into your DMs for the first time.
No, that's not true.
Yeah, I did.
Did you?
Should we find out?
Sure.
I DM'd you first on January 19th at 1:19 p.m. and said, can you marry me and cut my hair every other week, Dad?
What did I say?
You said, of course. And then, yeah. And then should we read through our DMs?
I mean, yeah.
Do you want to know my favorite line from this? Well, I DM'd you and said, wow, you're so hot. And then I replied to you again and you said, wow, you look so good. And you said, OMG, so do you. I said,
I said, OMFG.
So do you.
Okay.
And I sent back the gasp emoji and then you said, LOL, within the cute little emoji.
I'm not good at taking compliments.
No, I can tell. And then you asked me what I was doing. I said, just finish my makeup, sent you a selfie. And you said, can you do my makeup and I'll give you a haircut? I said, yeah, I guess. I said, I hate putting hot guys in makeup.
Yeah.
Which is true.
Smart. I wouldn't want to be in it, but I was just trying to make conversation.
And then you said, favorite line, here we go. LOL, I probably wouldn't like it, but I'll try anything once. Haha, almost everything.
Almost.
And I said, oh wow, I love that message. I love trying lots of things. One of my favorite pastimes is trying new things.
Have you ever hooked up with a girl?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah. Like made out, but like.
Was this before that you realized that you were gay?
Before and after.
Oh, so you went back for fun?
Yeah.
Wow.
Have you ever hooked up with a guy before?
No.
You should try it sometime.
No, I can't.
Then I said, I'm just bad at only flirting with straight guys who are interested. And he said, no, you're doing great.
So after all this, I didn't know much about you at this point. I was just joking around and stuff. But you told me that you have turned out straight guys. Elaborate on that because you are a famous celebrity. And you do live in Hollywood.
Yes.
Where there is a lot of guys that will be clout chasers is the new term that we're using. So you think it was somebody that was maybe looking for something in return from you?
Do you want my honest answer?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Yeah, let's talk about it. In science, in regards to like LGBTQ people, there's what's called the Kinsey scale. So the Kinsey scale is from like 0 to 6, 0 being like completely straight, and 6 being like completely gay.
Okay.
And I truly believe that the amount of people that are a flat out 0 or a flat out 6 is like very, very small. I think that most people are very close to the ends, but there's a huge percentage in the middle too. If I had to put myself on it, I would put myself at like a 5.5.
So you're not even full gay.
I mean, no, there have been girls in the past that I've like thought were really, really beautiful. There's also been like trans guys in the past too that I was like really, really into for a moment in time. Especially living in LA where everybody's like a lot more open-minded. I think that honestly, like majority of guys are like wanting to experiment.
I used to hear rumors like that all the time about like big, big celebrities like growing up. Everybody was like,
all the time.
What? Really? That's crazy. Cause I grew up in Staten Island where it was like, and I'm, you know, a couple years older than you. So my group of friends growing up, everybody was going for that same like tough guy, straight guy image. And I didn't have any gay friends. So it wasn't until I moved out that like I finally started meeting gay guys and working with them in like barbershops or salons and just like really having a relationship where like you get to talk to them about more than just the same bullshit.
100%,
you know?
Yeah. So like for me, for example, like I am a guy, I identify as a guy, but I still call myself a woman all the time, like as a joke and stuff. But like I do drag every once in a while. I have full nails, I have hair on occasionally.
Yeah.
So it's like for a lot of people, like they'll see me as someone who's just pretty as opposed to being like a man, which is fine. Like that's how I like to see myself as too. It's just someone who's like a pretty human
person.
Being. Yeah. So like a lot of people are willing to look past that and experiment and see like if they'd be into it just because it's something that they've either always wondered or they're into me as a person. And I think that's super, super cool. And unfortunately that a lot of times leads to a hookup or like making out or hanging out. And then the next day they're like regretting it, never talking to me again. Or there's internalized homophobia that has been built up so long that led to them wanting to experiment in the first place. But then once they do it, they're like, ew, gross. And then I'll start getting all sorts of death threats and angry messages from them the next day.
After you guys hook
after.
Up.
After. Or it'll be like a repetitive thing where it's like, hey, let's keep doing this on the DL. It's a very, very strange world, but it's like, you know what you're kind of getting into when you're behind the scenes. But I truly do feel like there's like a spectrum and everybody falls on it at some point. And like, especially right now too, like in the world, I feel like there's a major emphasis on like labels. And for me personally, like I do think labels are really, really important because it obviously spreads awareness. People can be educated, and also like young kids that don't feel welcome can be a part of something and can label themselves. But at the same time too, I also think like putting a label on something, especially as serious as sexuality, before you're fully understanding what it is can be really, really toxic.
I'm picturing the memes that are gonna be made from the zoom into me. Like, what am I thinking in my head right now?
Taking it all in?
I'm taking it in.
Yeah.
No, I get it. It makes
a lot of
sense.
I think it's just like, you should be able to experiment and like test out different things and talk to different people as like long as there's some sort of attraction there, whether it be to their personality, to their image, even to them sexually too. And like, it doesn't necessarily need to be something that you have to put a label on.
How do you deal with homophobic comments?
I don't care.
You don't start, you never did?
No.
Did you like grow out of that? Mm. Oh, is this the one where I brush on the highlight?
No, this is where you contour my face.
Okay, this is where the video, I didn't get to see the rest of it.
Did you get bored like 2 minutes in?
They were long videos.
Yes!
It was like 40 minute videos. So this goes around the bones?
Yeah, like right okay. Here to like make it me look nice and chiseled.
Okay, I went a little overboard on that side.
Oh, Jeff, pounce it in, pat it in, yeah. I have a question for you, Jeff, speaking in like relation to what you just asked me.
Yeah.
Because like after our video that we did together, there were a lot of people commenting, be like, wow, James and Jeff's like interaction was so cool. Jeff is so confident with himself. I knew you were straight, obviously, but like looking back, like it was really cool to watch. And like, it was funny too, because I feel like a lot of guys aren't comfortable enough with themselves to be able to make those type of jokes. How was that reaction for you?
The fan reaction was mostly positive. Sometimes in person, people will come up to me that I don't know and they joke around with my sense of humor. And they'll come up to me and be like, oh, where's your boyfriend at? Or something like that. I'm like, what the hell are you talking about at first? But then I get it, they're your fans and stuff like that, and they just know that I joke around a lot.
Yeah.
They want to make that first impression memorable to me. Yeah, so it was interesting. I'm getting used to it, but I'm always growing and trying to learn as a person. But I did see on Twitter some really positive tweets, and that was really cool to see that people could kind of move past that toxic masculinity. If I could have my audience and kind of do something positive, then I think that'd be pretty cool that we have that effect on Twitter, at least. You know,
we're a good duo.
Or YouTube.
Yeah.
Yeah, so let's keep it up. We're changing the world.
Done. Done, Jeff.
Nice. I think we're pretty good on this, though. I'm ready to move to the next step.
Okay.
I thought you were just going to pull out a Sharpie.
No. Okay.
So kind of what happens in barbering, you stretch the skin out. That's what you do with this, too, right?
Yeah.
I'm a natural.
You're so famous, Jeff.
Start my own makeup channel.
You should.
Oh, well, look at this. This is available right now.
It is. Sisters-apparel.com. Do you like to use the iconic James Charles X Morphe palette?
Oh, wow, yeah. About time a James Charles product comes out here.
It's the only one I have.
Is it?
Yes.
How come every time I hear somebody talking about James Charles, they're like, oh, this thing's sold out in minutes?
Because it is.
But this is what it is. This is the James Charles. Oh, look at this thing. All right, now I'm looking at this. I have no idea what's going on. There's so many different colors. This is harder than I thought.
No, it's not.
Let's do last year's Coachella look.
Oh God, okay.
This is crazy.
What was your first impression of me?
Very funny and like good at delegating responsibility to everybody and kind of organizing a shoot.
Thank you. But funny and organized are two great qualities.
Do me now. What was your first impression of me?
My first impression was that you were insanely hot. People know me for making like jokes at hot guys and stuff, but I was not ready for you to start making them back at me. So I was like, I was shook.
That looks nothing like that.
Oh, Jeff, the next question is, could you tell that your significant other liked you?
I mean, yeah.
What is your favorite thing your significant other has ever said to you?
I mean, probably just that, like, you thought my videos are funny. Because, like, you give me the compliments about, like, being good looking. I don't know how to take those. What was your favorite thing I've ever said to you?
Probably the Valentine's Day tags.
I don't want to. I can't do this, man. It was a joke.
It wasn't a joke.
It was just a friendly text. I sent it to all my guy friends.
I don't think you did.
You're right. Next question. So I'm gonna teach you guys a little trick, you guys at home. This I learned from barbering, but it could also work for a situation like whenever you go into a job on a new person, you're a little nervous no matter what. Yeah. I don't care what you say. It's like you have that fear of messing up.
Yeah, 100%.
You know, so what I would do on like a lineup, because the lineup you can't repair. So I would keep like one finger on the skin, mm-hmm. and now if you move or I'm a little shaky, my hand moves with your face. Mm-hmm. So you kind of have that like extra stability. So I think that'll work for something like this.
Put your hands all over me.
Put a little extra finger, is that okay?
I love a little extra
but
finger.
But don't be shy, get in on there and use that as your base.
Jeff, that actually looks so good.
Thank you.
That's like the best wing liner anybody's ever done.
I know, this is really my favorite part about makeup.
I can't believe you just did that.
I never pay attention to any other part.
Okay, good to know.
Stay still, we gotta do the other side. Sorry. It's not done yet. It's almost there.
How did you do one eye literally perfect and you can't get the other one even?
You know,
this is why I'm not getting a haircut from you.
I got overly confident. Yeah. It's not the same at all.
Yeah, it is.
You're right, it is. Next, you want to do the highlighter.
Sure.
Did I get it right?
Sure.
Highlighter is to highlight your bone structure.
Yes.
So we're going to highlight the areas where the light would hit you.
Yes.
You want to do a little tap?
Yeah. Where do you think you're going to put it?
I think here. Right.
Mm-hmm. If we got married, who would win in an argument?
I always let the significant other win.
Oh, thank God. Yeah, I'm winning, 100%.
Yeah, I just don't even bother.
Great, we're meant to be.
Well, what's next?
Would you like to put a lipstick on so you can really taste something nice at our date?
I don't like lipstick, man.
Oh, easier to make out with without it.
Yeah, it's just like...
This is true.
It's just like all this stuff on your face and you go to kiss. It's just something in the way that's gonna get on me now, and I'm not a fan of lipstick.
Never wearing lipstick again. Describe to me like your dream date.
Oh, I like iPic.
Yeah, the movie theater.
Yeah.
Super fun. It's a movie theater out here in LA where you can like, it's like lounge chairs, like you can like
recliners all the way. You could fully sleep if you want. There's a pillow, blankets.
And then you get to order comes food. Out,
brings you whatever you want. You could order candy from the waiter. It's not just regular food.
Yeah, it's kind of fun.
What is your dream date?
I would say I love a good movie. Like a good horror movie premiere would be amazing. I do love escape rooms. That's like my favorite thing to do in the entire world.
Not the biggest fan of escape rooms.
Really?
Yeah, I don't like how they treat you in there. It kind of reminds me of...
prison!
I'd rather probably do something else. Yeah, not my favorite thing to do.
Oh,
vulnerably put myself in those situations.
Of course, of course.
Check it out.
Are you ready for our date, Jeff?
This was it, I thought.
Jeff, this wing liner is so good.
Thank you.
All right, you guys. Well, I think this is the finished look from Daddy Jeff.
Let me know what you think. I'm reading through every comment.
You're so annoying. Thank you, Jeff, so much for coming on my channel today.
Thank you for having me. It's good to be here. I learned a lot, and I'm going to carry this knowledge on for the rest of my life. Not just about makeup, about life. And thank you, James. You taught me so much. My mind is opened.
That's good.
And I'm gonna be thinking about this for the whole day.
I'm definitely open as well. If you sisters enjoyed this video today, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up down below and leave us a comment. Let us know how you think Jeff did. If you've not already, make sure to click that big red subscribe button down below as well and come join the sisterhood. We are 16 million sisters strong. Oh my God, you guys, we literally just hit it this morning when we were filming this video. Thank you so much. Like. The support continues to blow my mind. I've honestly had a little bit of a rough month the past few weeks, and your guys' constant support, constant kind messages, and just everything in general, like, literally has kept me going so much. So I love you the absolute most in the entire world. If you have not already as well, click that bell icon so you get notification every time I upload a brand new video. If you want to go check out Jeff.
That's right. I just hit 16 boyfriend. Subscribers. I'm so grateful for all these 16 people.
Yeah. He does have some pretty funny haircutting content, I will say.
Oh, that's so nice of you. I didn't know you were gonna do a shout out for me. Thank you.
Yeah, duh. If you'd like to follow me on my makeup journey, you can follow me on Instagram and Twitter. They're both just James Charles. And my Snapchat for more behind the scenes stuff is James Charles, the next S after Charles. If you'd like to follow Jeff, it's just Jeff.
Yeah. If we get a million likes on this video, James is talking about releasing me back into the public and taking the chains off of my leg.
This video, sister shout out, goes to James as a queen. Love you the absolute most, sister. Thank you so much for always following and supporting. And if you would like to be the next video's sister shout out, don't forget to always retweet my video links when they go live on Twitter and turn on my YouTube post notifications by clicking that bell icon. All right, you guys, thank you so much for watching this video today. Thank you again to my incredible, beautiful future husband, Jeff. We love you and we will see you in the next one. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Please let me out of here.